And welcome back. This is the RPG Chick, and we are in Galawain's Maw, off of Old Song, I believe it's called, District? Yeah, Old Song District. Okay, so there's a brambles that we can chop through or something over there, and then there's this bridge here. We're fighting a lot of lions and stuff. There's a, I believe, a bear, if I remember correctly, and a lion that are hunters. They're supposed to hunt each other or some crap like that, and they're not. I mean, maybe they want to be friends or something like that. So, I don't know.
Keeping an eye out.
So we're keeping an eye out, and we're fighting tons of lions, and
got it.
I suppose at some point we'll be fighting tons of bears. It's not a lion. Make sure Kanna is right. Okay, he's right.
Following your lead.
Attack! Badly injured. Nice. We should rest soon. See if we can get rid of her completely. Holy Obedience. Flames of Devotion, Burning Sword type thing.
Following your lead.
Lava! I will be on seek!
Sounds like the pain of childbirth. Is he still doing that? Throw a fireball into the mix. Actually hit that guy without hitting our guys. Would be good. Not throw a blessing. Chunks. Mind blades. Can she reach? Because she hasn't used that yet. Throw a dare, a little healing.
Oh.
Maybe we can cast this. Blast of Frost. Thank you. your history, pal. Nothing out of the ordinary.
Slow.
Oh, trap detected as soon as he went to the sneak. Good thing we didn't run ahead some more.
Only now.
That's settled.
Excellent.
If it makes you rest easier.
Ooh, hidden thingy.
See now what the flame has shown us?
Yes, it has shown us a flask of war paint and a potion of iron skin. And we're full of crap. Don't we have war paint somewhere? Maybe I haven't seen this before. Plus 15 accuracy, plus 10% damage, plus 20% maximum endurance for 20 seconds. Binding the essence of sacrificed lives into a potent brew of blood and magic, war paint crafted by the Ethic Gnoll has empowered Glamfellen warriors to perform great feats of strength and dexterity for hundreds of years. Sounds familiar. Hmm. Oh, that's right, we can't even do that. Stuff can go in there, in our general crap. Yeah, that's better. Little bit. The mist rising from the depths feels heavy and warm. Oh! Oh no! Whoa! How do we blunder into that one? We didn't find that one.
Quickly and quietly.
Keeping an eye out.
We were all sneaking at that point, right?
Sure.
We already tripped it off. Burned lady. In reality, I would run back and camp, but makes as much sense to camp here. Okay. Better! We are better. Let's try not to run into any more traps. That'd be okay with you guys. Ooh, big area. Galawain Shrine. Oh-ho. Rinsey. An elven woman intercepts you as you advance into the lair. Behind her is the largest lioness you've ever seen, a sleek beast with fangs as long as carving knives. The woman blocks your path to the lioness, seemingly at ease around the monster. This is Sul's domain, Estremore. She shall not leave it for Oernos or Oernos, Oernos, I think, or any other challenger. What are you doing here with Sul? She looks at the lion with something between fondness and admiration. Defending the rightful champions of Galawain, defending the rightful champion, actually singular, of Galawain's maw, Oernos' supporters would have her ousted in favor of a bear that isn't strong enough to come and seize this territory on his own. Why does Sul refuse to face Oernos? Oernos is welcome to confront her here, as many challengers have in the past. What the bear supporters want is for Sul to leave her lair and fight in the open, where he has an advantage. But why should she? If Sul has an advantage here, it's one she's earned. Would anyone expect to blunt the bear's claws in order to even the odds? Well, I'm guessing the bear is the same thing. He says, come to my lair, but... The Lord of the Hunt gives unique advantages to each. It's not for us to decide that some of them are worth less than others. The lioness gives a low growl, and Arensi smiles. Also, Sul has recently given birth to cubs. They're small now, but when they grow, they'll be mightier than either Sul or Oranos. But if Sul is killed in combat, that bear will tear her young to shreds, such is the way of the wild. Her legacy is too valuable to perish this way. If we truly want the mightiest of beasts in the maw, then her cubs must grow to maturity. Okay. I'm not going to deal with... I don't know which one's right. I guess we got to hear the side of the other first. Ooh. Oh, that's a big bear. Makes everything quake. Mm-hmm. Einden says, here he comes. This barbarian keeps her chin down, her eyes darting from side to side. Well, is he coming here after all? Tufts of tawny fur and crushed grasses carpet a small hollow in the back of the cavern. The barbarian squares his shoulders and plants his feet as if ready for a fight.
I'm ready.
That's one of us, duh.
No problem.
A dense tangle of thorns blocks the path. The vines twitch and wriggle. Okay, so that's the way through to the other side. I guess he's coming, though, from here? We're here. Probably gonna meet him along the way.
Be cautious. Be constant.
But I don't think he'll just arrive if we just keep standing there.
What?
See now what the flame has shown us? What?
That's settled.
No problem.
Another one.
and the fire shows me something new. Hmm?
Damn it. I hate when that happens. Well, we could go all the way around to the other side. Why not?
If it makes you rest easier. I shall be quiet as a calm sea, which is not very quiet.
What's that? Another. That's just a tiny
and
trap.
And the fire shows me something new. Hmm?
Need more dialogues for when you find stuff.
That's settled.
Look at that.
No problem.
Nothing on this side, no secrets. Reveal your secrets. Nope. What's this do? Opens that. Okay. Alright, well, I don't know where they're coming from. Supposedly they're coming this way. Otherwise I'd stop sneaking. I'm not sure where exactly we saw them. yeah. So I'll just look at this again. I read this last time, but it's not a lot to read. A thick, snarled tangle of dagger-sharp thorns and vines has grown across this passage. As you look on, the entire wall of vegetation seems to move, almost like it were breathing. Thick coils of vines twist and writhe across the gap with a quiet rustle of foliage. Now, doesn't it just lead to the other side? Guess we'll find out. Examine the vines. Through the gaps in the twisting vegetation, you catch brief glimpses of what seems to be a wide circular chamber. From time to time, you catch the sight of tawny hides, and the rustling of the vines is briefly obscured by low growls. Yeah, we've been there. Well, we'll probably get experience for going through here. Force your way through. You stride boldly forward into the tangle of vines, only to find them as thick and tough as trees. The vines stir to life immediately upon contact, and soon you are surrounded by a writhing mass of thorns and cutting leaves. Great. One vine finally swings towards you like a slung club, and you find yourself knocked unceremoniously back in the direction you came. The quiet rustling of the vines has become a roar, echoing through the maw. Alright, well, if we go through the other way, try to sneak through instead of force our way through, you find a brief opportunity as two vines move in opposite directions, clearing a path, and you carefully step forward. Ooh. You start off well, moving carefully around and past the web of plants, but halfway through, Palagina steps on a dry, dead branch, and a vine suddenly darts forward with unnatural speed. The vines tighten mercilessly around Palagina's leg, and the ensuing struggle shakes the surrounding vegetation, stirring it into a writhing frenzy. Palagina finally tears her way free and limps out past the edge of the wall. You step out into the next chamber. Oh, that was fun. We might have to choose one or another. I'll deal with Oernos. Good. That bear isn't nearly as strong as Einden and his followers think. If someone were to prove just how easily that bear can be killed, that would cure everyone of their delusions about it. Any news of the bear? Yeah. Ooh, a hidden thingy.
Eyes open.
Gauntlets of swift action. Plus 15% attack speed. Plus 0.01 to crit damage multiplier. Yeah. For a dare. Yes, we dare. Now, I don't know. Are we going to come across him now? We will deal with Oernos. The only question is, where is he? There's Oernos. Bear clanswoman. Bear clansman. Einden sighs, spinning his axe by the shaft. Too much waiting. Something's gotta happen. Soon. We haven't talked to him before, but this is grayed out. What are you doing here?
We wait for the big confrontation. But the wait grows exhausting. While Sue hides in the back of the maw. Oernos is denied his victory, and we're all denied the champion we deserve.
He grimaces and runs a thumb along the edge of his axe. Oernos isn't the rightful champion.
If you stand on the side of that toothless old bag of bones, then you stand in my way.
He hefts his axe. The bear growls. Well, I wish we had one of these options. Try me. This is where we came in. Oh, he's just... They just came out of nowhere, these guys? Figured they'd have a little lair as well. Okay, start combat. Paladin run up. Who is this? Palagina. Boom. Boom. Concussive missiles. Try to take out this Einden guy first.
What?
Holy Radiance. Fireball. She's been really low lately on focus. Mind blades off of. Well, he's probably gonna die soon. Screamed. They're werebears. Blessing. Alagina. Boom. Canna. Boom. She's barely injured, get it? She's out of focus. Let's use concussive missiles again. Pillar of faith on the bear. Oh, Oernos is not tough at all. I can confirm. Does she have any? No, okay. He's dead.
Following your lead.
That was easy. Exceptional battle axe. Alright. I've resolved the stalemate between the beasts. Deathswain will want to know the outcome. Well, we'll talk to the lions as well.
Got it.
They want to know what happens. Should we try to go through these vines again? Now that we've found a way? Through? Once? Wait a second. Oh, it's over here. Oh, I gotta watch out for that trap. Don't! Oh, that Palagina. I've dealt with Oernos. You chose well. Soul's cubs will grow up to be quick and fierce, and so will the fangs if we follow their example. She looks at the sleek lioness. Thank you for resolving this, Estremor. Soul's clubs will grow into the mightiest hunters that have ever roamed Ir Glanfath. Seriously? No prize or anything? As you walk forward, the vines shift and their thorns retract, providing you with a clear and safe pathway through. You emerge unscathed on the other side. Good. But they like us now, because we helped their... I guess that... It was working for them. So, the lioness and... Irenia, whatever the hell her name is.
Still looking around? Watch your step. Tempers run hot around here, and not just among the animals.
I've dealt with the situation between Sul and Oernos. And Sul remains champion. Many of the Fangs are gladdened to see her stay. Perhaps it's Galloway's way of telling us to remember our roots and prize our cunning as hunters. Thank you for your help, Kared? That's a new one. May Galloway guide your path. Take this with our thanks. He seems to suddenly remember something. You might visit Tyr Evron to pray to the Lord of the Hunt. He sometimes grants special favors for those who prove themselves. Okay, where's that again? I don't remember. Taxes collected. Now we can focus our energies on hunting again. So what... Minor adventure added. I don't think I've picked, what's his name? Haravius lately. So we gained a cat's claw. That's a torch. Cat's claw. Huh. A unique sword, one-handed. +8 accuracy. +30% damage. 3 damage reduction bypass. Exceptional weapon. A knight once roamed the living lands in pursuit of adventure. Adventure. So few knew his name, all recognized him by his blade, a graceful weapon fixed to a lion's head pommel, and a crossguard shaped like rending claws, and by the black cat that followed at his heels. While some believed the cat to be the knight's companion and familiar, others claimed that she was a spirit-shifted druid who had forged a knight's sword with a piece of her essence. The blade, long and slender, was said to slash at the soul of the knight's opponents. Well, the one with the one-handed sword is Palagina. Sorry, guys. Tidefall. Hold up. Before, after. Ooh, cat's claw. Oh, no. Tidefall's better. Look at that. 21 to 30 instead of 15 to 22. Tidefall has a better interrupt. Although Cat's Claw is faster. +12% accuracy. +45% damage. I gotta say Tidefall is a better one. No one else is using... Well, she's got two-handed. This is what, one-handed? It is one-handed. My bad. Hold on. Let me see. I'd give it to him if one-handed... So he's using two-handed. Yeah, that's one-handed. And she's using two-handed. I I want to see if he has proficiency in... Weapon Specialization Knight. Battle Axe, Sword, Morningstar Crossbow. So he can use a sword. Oh, and he has Weapon Focus. In Ruffian, that's the difference. That's what screwed me up all this time. I didn't realize he has weapon specialization in Knight, but weapon focus in Ruffian. Now I'm wondering if we can take weapon focus in Knight as well. Saber, stiletto, club, pistol, blunderbuss. It's a skill? No. It's a... Well, technically it's a talent. Anything about talents here? Huh. All right, I don't know. Ooh, I gotta read this! This is awesome! Next time I'm gonna read this, my journal. I didn't even realize this was here. Well, I'll see what I can do next time. Let's leave this way. I wanna see if I can take that talent for a sword.
I have sailed many places with the Duke's fleet, Scanner, but never have I seen the famed coral harbor of Rawatai.
It is worth the journey north, I promise you. Especially now that the Gate of Great Teeth is finished. A labyrinth of towering spires, gleaming red in the sun.
I doubt my duties will ever take me there, but at least your words have given me something to dream of.
Okay, still wondering about this. Now, the thing about the stiletto that I like is it's fast. But wow. The difference in damage, though. And it's not like this is a slow weapon. It's still average. And this has a better interrupt. As well. This doesn't hit as often. Plus 5 accuracy. Yeah, I say give him this and see what we can do about. Give him a little shock damage. We need to get some... We need to level up our enchantment somehow. Or... we'll get some more equipment. Cool, making potions. I don't use them very often. But I wonder if you can level up in enchanting or crafting that way. How's our reputation with the fangs? Neutral? Twin Elms, neutral. Aloth's done. Look at this. Aloth, kicking butt. Most damage taken, though, a dare. And most times knocked out. Aloth, 21 times. Most powerful enemy defeated. Aloth. The final blow on Warchief Iklak. Endurance. Got the last blow on Kale the Silent. Awesome. We have fought 1,305 enemies, guys. We've been in combat for over 3 days. That's crazy. I didn't realize I can go into that way. Next time we'll go to Noomfrost, or attempt to anyway. Thanks for watching. See you next time, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.